Now we'll perform the analysis of this array that was read. So we have all the values read in the production quantity, which has a number of years values. And what we like to do is to compute and print various statistics about this array. And first of all, first one is to compute the minimum from the array. And because we know that the array has at least one value, make no sense to analyze an empty array, we may say, okay, if we want to compute the minimum, let's assume the minimum is, so the minimum value will be the first element in the array, or the minimum quantity will be the first element in the array, so the one on index 0. So this will be the first, the initialization for the minimum, and then we'll go through all the other values in the array and see if they are better minimums. So they are less than the minimum that we currently have. And if they are better minimums, so they are less than the minimum, then we will update the minimum to keep that particular value. So what we'll do, we'll go through all the remaining elements. So we'll loop with a for from the next element, which has the index 1. We'll go until the end of the array, so less than number of years. And we'll increment with 1 each time when we at each iteration of the loop. And now in the loop, we want to check if my minimum is okay or if my current value, production quantity of I, it's a better minimum. To be a better minimum means that it's less than my current minimum. And if this happens, if the value on which I am currently, it's less than minimum value, means I have another candidate to be, a better candidate to be the minimum value, which is my current value. So if we do this for all the numbers in the array, at the end, the minimum value will keep the best minimum, which is a minimum from the entire array. Basically, always minimum value will keep the value of the minimum of all the elements up to the current index. So let's write minimum value, and now we can just put this minimum value. Let's see now what the minimum value will be. And as you can see, it's 5710. And if we look briefly over the values, we can see that this seems to be indeed the smallest value in my array. Now, this concludes the computation of the minimum value.